In Exodus chapter 3 verse 9, the word of God says, "Now therefore behold, the cry of the children of Israel is come unto me, and I have also seen the oppression wherewith the Egyptians oppressed them." He said, "The cry of the children of Israel have come unto me." Yes, the cry have come also unto me, and I've seen each and every of the things that was done against them. God wants you to know today, dear child of God, that everything that was done against you, everything that the enemies had used to oppress you, everything that the enemies had done to subject you to pains, today God is bringing his good news to you that every of this oppression will be gone. Yes, and every of these people that oppressed you, they would be seeing his wrath. Yes, his strange, terrible side they would see. Every of those people that had afflicted you, every of these people that brought pains to your life, is telling you today, in the process of time, you would discover that he's going to bring his vengeance, his wrath against each and every one of them, and none of them would escape. The Lord wants you to know that by the reason of the bondage you are in, he turned his direction to you, and now he's going to be responding on your behalf, to see that everything that was done against you is stopped forever, and none of them would ever continue. God is saying to you today, every of the pains you had gone through, every of the sorrows you had experienced, is going to deal with each and every one of them. And he would make sure that everyone who stood against you, yes, the people that masterminded these things, the people that caused you to sorrow, the people that caused you to be in pains, is going to do something that when you see the things that he has done, you would be amazed yourself. He said, "Only with your eyes you will see the reward of the wicked." Because every day, everything they were doing against you, they were sowing a seed, and today they are going to be reaping the reward of their evil. He said they will reap the reward of their wickedness. Dear child of God, the oppression will be gone. The sufferings, the pains, the sorrow, the hardness, the hardship will be gone. You were asking yourself, "What did I do to them? What did I do to them to hate me this way? What did I do to them to pick on me this way?" God have seen every of these things. You see, God knows all the things that you had experienced, and this is why he's bringing this word to you, that your day of celebration is coming, your day of promotion is coming, that will cause you to forget the pains and the oppression that you went through. Joseph was wondering, "What did I do? What did I do to get all of these things happening to me? What did I do? What did I do to be locked in the prison? What did I do? What did I do for my siblings? What did I do against those ones that I called my own brethren to do evil against me? What did I do?" He was asking questions, but God responded to him with his favor. Dear child of God, everything that was done against you, God wants you to know that that is the reason he is going to favor you. That is the reason he's going to announce you. That is the reason he is going to settle you. That is the reason he's going to bless you. When the Lord saw the afflictions that was done against God's people, God made sure that he sent gold to where they were. God made sure that he blessed them and sent them forth. The more they were crying, the more the burdens increased, and then their groanings went to God. God made sure that they were going to receive a blessing. I want you to know that for the things you have experienced, for the sorrows, the pains, and the hardship, God is going to bring something your way that will cause you to forget everything that you had ever experienced. Joseph was locked in the prison, but by the time the blessing came, when the promotion came, he did not remember those pains anymore, because God had taken every of those sorrows, God had taken every of these afflictions, God had taken every of these pains away. He said in his word, "If thou afflict them in any wise, and they cry at all unto me, I will surely hear their cry." Exodus 22, verse 23. He said, "I will surely hear their cry, and I will respond." And he responded and made sure he changed their story. Dear child of God, today God wants you to know that every time you come to Him, every time you are being in His presence, every time you went to His footstool, crying to Him and asking Him to visit you, He wants you to know that none of those times was a waste of time. He wants you to know that none of those times were wasted time, because He heard everything that you said. He saw your teardrops. He saw everything that came from you. He saw your groanings, and now He's going to respond. He knew every time you went to the altar crying to Him and He's saying to you, you are going to receive your promise. You are going to receive your blessing. You are going to receive the answers, and your joy will be full. Anna went to God. She was in pain. She was in the heaviness of heart. She was groaning. She was crying. She was sobbing before God. And God responded. God responded and brought a bundle of joy that she would rise up in 1 Samuel chapter 2 verse 1. And she had praises to sing unto God. She had celebration to bring to God, because God changed her story. Because God gave her a testimony. Because God gave her a reason to rejoice. Because God gave her a reason to dance. Dear child of God, God will give you a reason to rejoice. God will give you a reason to dance. God will give you a reason to celebrate. God will give you a reason to be excited. God will settle you on all sides, and you would know that God have done you well. You will know that God had changed your story. What God did for Anna made her to rejoice. What God did for Anna made her to celebrate. What God did for Anna made her to forget the days that she was crying, the days that she was in pains, the days that she experienced sorrow. He said, and Anna in prayer before the Lord said, my heart is glad in the Lord. 1 Samuel chapter 2 verse 1. He said, my horn is lifted up in the Lord. My mouth is open wide over my haters, because my joy is in your salvation. She said that my mouth is open wide over my haters. Dear child of God, God knows everything that your haters did. He knew how they laughed at you. He knew how they made you cry. But now, He's telling you, are going to enter into that season of joy, into that season of celebration, into that season of dancing, into that season of rejoicing, that you will not remember the pains, the sorrows, the heaviness, the things that you went through ever again, in the mighty name of Jesus. You would be able to say, there is no other God except you. You are the only powerful God. That was what Anna was saying when God brought that gladness and joy to her. When God changed her story, she said that there is no one. There is no one like a rock. There is no one like a God who could do those wonderful things. Dear child of God, the Lord will do something in your life, and you would be able to say, no one would have been able to do this if not God. You would be able to say, if not God who showed up for me, then my life would have been in ruins. You would be able to say, if not for God that arose for me and fought for me, maybe my story would have been a forgotten one by now. If not for God who stood for me and fought for me, maybe I would have been a write-off right now. Dear child of God, this was the testimony of Anna, knowing that God showed up for her and changed her story, brought joy and rejoicing to her, and made sure all the afflictions, the pain, the oppression, the sorrow, the mockings, the laughings, and everything was gone. And she saw what God did, and she would be able to say, my mouth is open wide over my haters, because my joy is in your salvation. It says, I am stronger than my enemies because of what God have done. She said, I am happy because you, Lord, have saved me. Dear child of God, this is how God will save you. This is how God will give you reasons to be happy. This is how God will give you reasons to rejoice. This is how God will give you reasons to celebrate. And you would be able to say, only in the Lord do I have my victories. Dear child of God, you would be able to say, only in the Lord has my breakthrough come. You would be able to say, only in the Lord have I seen my salvation, and I've come into my place of rest, and I've come into my place of dancing, and I've come into my place of rejoicing. These would be your testimony as well. These will be your testimony, dear child of God, and your joy will be full because of the great wonders of God that is going to be visible in and around your life in the mighty name of Jesus. I want to say to you congratulations because you are the next to testify. I want to say to you congratulations because all of the oppressions, the sorrow, the hardship, the pains, the sadness, the crying, the heaviness, the weepings, every of the troubles and sorrows will be gone. And you would not remember any of them anymore in Jesus' mighty name. And the Lord will continually say to you, in Jesus' name, amen. It is well with you, beloved. God bless you and shalom.